Reducibility. Okay, this topic is needed when we are probing some problems or np-complete problems. Okay, so by reducibility means that a problem q can be reduced to another problem q dash if any instance of q can be easily rephrased as an instance of q dash. That is, we are reducing a problem means that we are converting one problem to another problem. That is called a problem reduction. Okay, for example, you consider this linear equation ax plus b. Okay, this linear equation can be reduced to quadratic equation by simply adding a 0 x square in the equation. Okay, so the value of equation does not change here. Okay, well, the variable value, everything will be remain the same because we are adding 0 x square, but it is converted to a quadratic equation. Okay, so this process of conversion is called reducibility or reduction. Note that by reduction means we are not reducing any complexity or we are not reducing number of variables and all. We are just converting the problem to another class of problem. Okay, so we are just rephrasing the problem. Okay, and we need the concept of reducibility in proving some problems are NP complete, because we will take one NP complete problem and reduce the given problem to that problem so that our effort will be reduced. Okay, so formally a language L1 is polynomial time reducible to another language L2 written as L1 reducible to L2 like this. Okay, this P means we are reducing it in polynomial time. Okay, so the reducibility must happen in polynomial time. If there exists a polynomial time computable function, that function will map from 01 to 01 star. Okay, 01 star to 01 star. I hope you know about the language denotation that you studied in theory of computation, such that if x belongs to L1, if and only if f of x belongs to L2. Okay, so this function must be reduced, it must be a polynomial time reduction function. Okay, and we call this function as reduction function, and the algorithm which compute this function is called a reduction algorithm. Okay.